Metals are on the left side of the periodic table, that is on the left of metalloids, and metalloids are on the zigzag line in the periodic table, while the nonmetals are on the right side, of course, except hydrogen. The type of element can be used in determining the bond type. So we have the type of elements and the bond type. Ionic bond, the type of elements are metal and nonmetals. In covalent bond, the type of elements are nonmetals. In metallic bond, the type of elements are all metals. In ionic bond, it is formed when a metal transfers its valence electrons to nonmetals and they become positive ion, while nonmetals gain electrons to become negative ion, and they do so in order to become stable. And how is it to become stable? To gain a full octet electrons in their outer energy level. While covalent bond is formed when both nonmetals share electrons. Again, to become stable, that is to gain a full octet of electrons in their outer energy level. Now, in the periodic table, we learned that the group number is the number of valence electrons. So, if the element belonging to group 1A, it has one valence electron, and they need to lose one electron in order to become stable. In group 2A, they have two valence electrons. They need to lose two electrons to become stable. In group 3A, containing three valence electrons, they need to lose three electrons to become stable. And in 4A, four valence electrons, they need this time to share four electrons, and they form four bonds. In group 5A, they have five valence electrons, and to achieve octet rule, the eight valence electrons, they need to share three electrons, so they form three covalent bonds. While the group 6A, they have six valence electrons, they share two electrons to form two covalent bonds, or they may gain two electrons. Also in group 5A, they may gain three electrons, and in 4A as well. So in 7A, they have seven valence electrons. They need to share one electrons and they form one covalent bond, or they may gain one electrons in order to become stable. So that is why the group 1A, like lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, and cesium, after losing one electrons, in order to become stable, they gain one positive charge. Thus, the symbol of the ions are the symbol of the element with the positive one charge. Likewise, in group 2A, which are example beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, and barium, they acquire two positive charges after losing electrons. That is why the symbol of the ions are their symbol plus the two positive charges. group 3A, example is aluminum, acquires 3 positive charges after losing 3 electrons. Therefore, the symbol of the ion is aluminum 3 positive. In group 5A, example are nitrogen, phosphorus, and arsenic. After gaining 3 electrons to become stable, they acquire 3 negative charges, and the symbol of the ions are the symbol of the element plus the 3 negative charge. In group 6A, example are oxygen, sulfur, and selenium. After gaining 2 electrons, they acquire 2 negative charges, thus the symbol of the ions are the symbol of the element with 2 negative charge. Group 7A, example are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. The charge of the ion is negative 1 after they gain 1 electrons. Thus, the symbol of the ions are the symbol of the elements with negative 1 charge. So, let us have an illustration on formation of ionic compounds. Again, ionic compounds are composed of metal, the one that loses electrons, and the non-metal, the one that gains electrons. So, let's have an example here. Sodium belonging to group 1A and chlorine belonging to group 7A. They will form ionic compound. So, we learned that sodium belonging to group 1A has 1 valence electron. So, we will designate it with this dot. And this chlorine belonging to group 7A has 7 valence electrons. So, let us draw the 7 dots. Remember the electronic dot symbol lesson before? So, now this one electron, the valence electron of sodium, it will transfer to chlorine. So, that now you have 8 valence electrons with chlorine atom. So, what happened? Sodium now, after losing this electron, sodium now becomes sodium 1 positive, and chlorine, after gaining 1 electron, it becomes Cl1 negative, and the compound is NaCl, an ionic compound. Okay, let us have magnesium. Magnesium belongs to group 2A. Therefore, it has 2 valence electron. And oxygen here belonging to group 6A has 6 valence electron. 2, 4, 6. So, as you can see, magnesium will transfer the 2 electrons, the valence 2 electrons, so that oxygen now will have 8 valence electrons. So, after that, what happened? Magnesium losing 2 electrons become Mg2 positive and oxygen becomes O2 negative. Therefore, we have an ionic compound, MgO.